All right, so now it's time to get the tour of the house. As you can see, this picture behind me, you probably remember it from my other house in Seaford, New York. It's down here now. It's now decorating this house, as well as some of my other paintings you'll see around the house. And I don't need to, do everything. I'm just going to show you some of the highlights that I feel of the house. You know, it's a much bigger house than I had in New York. New York, it's very expensive. You can't have a house this size. You know, this is 2 acres of property, so we never would be able to. It would have been millions, in New York, And so this is a great opportunity for me to have more room so I can have more animals on my property. We can have a pool, that kind of stuff. And it's much more affordable here, but I want to show you exactly what attracted me to this house. First of all these walls surrounding the outsides of the house are all poured concrete. So we're upstairs and downstairs, which is great because there's hurricanes here in Florida, much more regular hurricanes than they have in New York, and that's not good. And so we, at least we know if the hurricane comes, we're not gonna get blown over. I love this bay window as you're looking out right now into my backyard. Chris Aceto loves this window. Chris likes to look out the window while he's drinking his coffee in the morning. And you can see there's a creek. It's called Gator Slough Creek. And running through the back of my house, there's actually alligators in there. My wife Amanda has spotted about a 4-foot alligator. He sometimes comes out and basks on the other shore. Maybe we'll catch him later. Logan is mad that he's not on camera. The backyard, as you're looking at it right now, will be completely changed probably within a year. We're going to put a pool with a pool cage back there eventually. Right now we're building our facility, so we can't do that right now. We've planted a lot of fruit trees I'll show outside as well. So this view is great because I sit here on my computer, my laptop, I do my work, and I can look out the window, whether it be night or day, and it's like a great view. It gives you a nice positive mental image of what's going on. All right, here's our living room, which once again, we're still in construction here because we're constructing, so we have a lot more stuff in the house than we should, but we're setting up stuff. This is Amanda's couch she had from her house. I love this couch, it's very comfortable. As you can see, this was kind of like an entertainment center they had set up here. I don't really like it, to be honest with you. I actually want to rip it out because I want to put a big like 70-inch screen TV here, and it just doesn't fit. I don't know what this was made. This was made for the old cube TVs, I think, that they used to have. Although, the funny thing is this house was only built 10 years ago, so I don't know why they did this. It looks nice, but it's really not that functional. We also have a fireplace over there, which we have to block off with because Logan likes to get in there, and Jedi likes to get in there, so we block that off. If you come over here, you'll see my, this is our computer room, which is still very messy because we have all my Dave Palumbo and a lot of Species Nutrition stuff in there because we're doing a lot of shipping out of here right now until we get the new warehouse going. This is my desk that Amanda's mom redid. I don't know if you ever saw it in my other office in New York, but this, she did an amazing job on this thing. This thing is completely refinished. It looks brand new. And as you can see, I got our old, that was the old Whack Pack crew that was here. And I got my, I have all my little Zen-like statues here. But they're all kind of clogged over by boxes of stuff that we have here because, like I said, we do all the shipping out of here for DavePalumbo.com products, and we have some Species Nutrition products that I actually use myself in here. So this will all be cleared out. I got my Muhammad Ali picture on the wall, and we're all set to go. So this is the computer room. Then we'll go into the bedroom. The good thing about these Florida houses is the master bedroom is downstairs, so I don't have to walk up the steps, really. And this is our room. We just got this new bedroom set pretty recently. As you can see, there's extra couches in here that won't be here because these are gonna go over to our studio. So we still have a lot of junk in here, which is driving me crazy. We got Logan's crib in the room with us still. We got a nice bathroom. It's pretty big and spacious. I love it. Although we're gonna be probably changing up the shower. Let me put some lights on in here. Personally, I don't bathe. I don't take baths. And I don't think most people take baths nowadays. So this tub is a waste of space for me. I would rather just, I want to rip this out and I want to make a huge shower stall like out of my other house. Now, if you look, this shower stall is pretty good. If you catch, it's open. I like shower stalls that don't have doors on them. So this is great in that sense, but it's not big enough. I want to pull the tub out and I want to build a huge shower stall. So that's one of our future projects. The good thing about having a big house is you could have future projects and you don't run out of projects. All right, I'm at the base of my steps here. I actually have two staircases in the house, on each side of the house, which is kind of cool. I don't know if I'll ever use them. I'm sure my kid will be running down one as I'm going up the other looking for him when he gets a little older. But I got another painting from my house in Seaford. One of my favorites. It's called Symphony of Souls. It's actually an original I bought. The only original painting I own. All right, so let's go up these very steep stairs here. You got to be careful. You got to hold the railing. You know, I have stair problems, and these are very steep, high stairs, but that's okay. All right, we're up here on the second level, and I wanted to show you this great painting. There was these guys drove around in vans with painting artwork, and I actually really liked this painting, but I really didn't want to pay them what they wanted for it. So I had another painting that I wanted to actually get rid of that was actually worth some money. I actually traded them. So I'm actually an art trader now, unbeknownst to me. And so I got this great painting here. I don't know what you'd call it, but it's kind of cool. It's got very pastel-y, and it's just, it's my kind of art style. I like it a lot. And so this is the only new thing I've bought since I've gotten here. Everything else is pretty much from the old house, as you can see. This is my entertainment center in my living room, my old house. Now this is our little sitting room. We just bought this new couch. It reclines, love it. Once I actually have cable and internet in my house, I could sit and I could watch my old TV and I could watch, you know, YouTube, and I could watch all our RXMuscle.com programming here in the lap of luxury. I even decided to put my little coffee table book. This is David Paul, one of the Barbarian Brothers. The Art of Bodybuilding, Volume 1. There was never a Volume 2. And got his signature on there. It's a great book. That's Lee Priest, actually, on the cover. And they got some great, great pictures in here. I don't know if you guys have ever seen this. I don't even know if he has it for sale anymore. It's probably the only copy around. It's Christian Boving there. Is that Chris Cormier? Or is that Rico? Rico. Mike O'Hearn. These are like O'Hearn pictures before O'Hearn was even like popular. No one even knew who really was back then. This has got to be 15 years ago, maybe more. That's when I think he was dating that girl at the time. John Sherman. Flex Wheeler. This was a classic picture of Flex Wheeler in the desert. David Paul actually got this grand piano and took it out into the desert with Flex and these two girls and shot him in the desert. Crazy, right? Look at that. All right, so this is our upstairs bedrooms now. There's actually three, and then there's a playroom, so it's actually pretty big up here. This would, I guess we would call this the guest room now, the way we have it decorated. This is, you know, if we have anyone stay over and they wanna come here, you know, not that I'm inviting anyone, but if I do, they can come here. This is a little connecting bathroom. This is actually, that will actually be probably one of the baby's rooms, you know, down the road. We have obviously a bathroom in here where this would be Logan's bathroom, I guess. And if you walk through, we're in Logan's bedroom here. And he's got a lot of toys here and stuff that grandma brought him because grandma likes to spoil Logan. I gave him my extra Spider-Man poster, which is not really a poster. I think I've said this before on old videos. That's actually a towel that I bought in Isles of Adventure in, I guess you could say, Universal Studios. And it was such a great towel that I couldn't bear to use it. So I actually had it framed, and it's a really cool looking thing. A lot of people always, I've actually been offered money. When I was selling some of my other artwork in my other house before I moved, someone offered me money, but I wouldn't sell it. So here's Logan's room. And then if you come down the hallway here, you'll see our big guest room we have. This is Amanda's old bedroom set up here. Logan is hanging out on the floor here. And we actually had to live in here for a little while because we didn't have a bedroom set when we first moved, because I sold my bedroom set, and this has a bathroom in here. So this is a nice big room, and you know, it has a lot of light in here. I like how it's decorated. And if anyone comes over that we really value, we will put them in this room. All right, this brings us to the game room, we call it. It's a huge oversized room. It could actually be an apartment. You know, it's so big. Amanda's got her treadmill in here and some of her exercise equipment. Logan's got all his toys in here. We have a little entertainment area set up here. This was an old TV that the people who lived here before kind of left. As you can see, I got my Chris Angel signed poster on the wall there from Chris Angel. That's from my other house as well. I got my dad's novels on the wall there, the covers framed. And we got a little kitchen up here, which is kind of cool. So, you know, if you want to, like, you know, have some drinks up here, and, you know, this will probably be, my son will probably use this as a game room for his kids, for his friends. We'll throw them in here so we don't hear them, and they can do whatever they want and kill each other in here. And then we have, of course, a little bathroom here, which is kind of cool. So I could lock all the kids in here, and they could all stay in here. If they make a mess, it's not a big deal. They're not going to ruin the rest of my house. So this is pretty cool. I got my yoga mat on the floor that the Jedi loves, and Logan lays on all the time here. Okay, it's time to go to the groomer here today, too. This is a busy day. Fridays are busy days. So we got Penny here. Hi, give kisses. Okay, we got Diva. And they're both dirty dogs, and they're going to the groomer, Amanda. Everyone knows Amanda, who doesn't like to come on camera, so this is a very big thing for you.
It's very big. No camera time. You're the star.
Yeah, Amanda drops them off at the groomer. I pick them up before I go to work, so that's the routine. And these guys have a day of beauty right ahead of them. All right, guys, now this is Logan's favorite part of the day, where I take him in his red car that Grandpa Sal bought him, and we take him for a walk. We can actually see the property. If you look over there, that's my bottle palm tree. It's very small now. I just planted a little while ago. Amanda and I put in the ground. And that's my dragon fruit plant, which is very small right now, but they have delicious tasting fruits, this one. It grows on that trestle right there. These are some flowering plants that we have that kind of look cool. I always wanted cool looking plants, and I think this is a bird of paradise flowers. Mm-hmm. Those are pretty cool. There's one, we have a white one, and we have an orange one. If you look over there, over to our left, you can see a tree, like in the middle of the, right in the middle over there. That is what they call a fruit cocktail tree. It actually could have up to six different citrus fruits on it. Could have, we're not even sure what's on there. It could have navel oranges, grapefruits, lemons, Meyer limes. They kind of splice in all the different fruits into the same tree. It's pretty cool. And Logan and I usually go up and down the driveway, but we're gonna take a right out of my property here. We're gonna go to the end of my property, because I wanna show you some of the other fruit trees we planted. You know, hopefully in a couple of years, we'll get some really cool fruit. I always wanted to have fruit trees on my property. Unfortunately, in New York, that's not actually very viable. I'm walking here with Grandma too, Grandma Denise, who's helping out. Grandma Denise comes when Amanda leaves to work. Logan, this is a pretty bumpy road, huh?
He likes it like that.
He does? Say hi to the camera.
Say hi.
Hi, wave.
Clap your hands. Clap Logan's hands. Hurry up.
All right, we're out here in my yard now, my side yard. This is where I have all our trees planted. And this is my honey bell tangelos. These are amazing oranges. We actually have one. I can't believe it. I didn't even see it. If you look at it's green now, obviously. Once it turns orange, we'll pick it. Honey bells are amazingly juicy. I like to just cut them and just eat them. I mean, it basically just falls out of the fruit. They're super, super juicy. We bought this tree a little bigger because we're impatient. This tree should be a great tree. This tree right here is, I believe, our cherry tree. I think this is our cherry tree we planted. And this is growing pretty nicely. Although, you know, you gotta remember, it's winter here. So in winter here, things kind of don't bloom all year round. They kind of like go almost like the fall is in New York. Hopefully this tree will come back as the spring approaches. We have our grapefruit tree. We have a grapefruit tree that, I'm a big grapefruit eater, especially red ruby grapefruits are amazing. They don't even need any sugar in them. This is that tree. Once again, I'm sure it'll pick up. This is, which tree is this one? I don't even remember. No, this is the red ruby. This is our red ruby grapefruit. Sorry, that was our cherry tree. Or I think that was our starfruit tree, excuse me. The one we just saw was the starfruit tree. This is our grapefruit tree. And here, over here, is our banana trees. But these bananas are pretty cool. They're mini bananas, actually. And these things, what happens with the banana trees is they grow, and then the leaves die and they fall off. So they look really shabby, but they always have new sprouts here. And eventually the bananas will just drop here, and they'll be right here and they're probably this big. They're little mini yellow bananas. They're delicious. So these grow really fast. We should have some good fruit from these pretty soon. And if you look to my right yard over there, that's where eventually we'll put the pool. That's the back of the house. So here we are at the new facility. This is going to be RXMuscle Species Nutrition headquarters here. And I'm lucky, when I bought this house, there was this big metal building on it that they were storing an RV in and a boat. And I said to myself, this thing is really tall. I said, I could probably put two levels on this. So we sat down with an engineer and we sat down with an architect and we actually put together this building. And it's little by little coming up. You can see all the electricity is in right now. They wired us, everything's wired. Once the walls are open, everything gets wired. This bottom floor here, believe it or not, will be where I keep my animals. I have my snakes down here. I could put my turtles down here. Anything I want to do that's exotic that I don't want in the house, I can put my fish tanks if I decide to get more fish tanks. Everything will go down here. I have three rooms. This is the main room. I call the boa constrictor room because those are the big snakes. The room next to it, as you can see, is going to be like my ball python room, and probably, like I said, if I put any fish tanks in here, or although I might just keep this strictly reptiles. And then the room next door, I'm going to have a desk in here, over here, and I might put some fish tanks here. I don't know. This is like the overflow. You know what happens invariably is when you have animals, you always keep getting more and more and more. So it's good that I have expansion capabilities. So that's this downstairs, but the exciting, real exciting part is what goes on upstairs. So follow me. I'm going to give you a little tour of what the new RXMuscle Species Nutrition offices are going to look like. All right, so now we're coming upstairs in the new facility. This is the exciting thing, the window skin. We actually have to put two windows up here, which I really didn't want to do because it was unnecessary, but you know, for safety and emergency evacuation type of situation, we have to be able to get out of here. So they're going to be putting two windows in here. As you can see, this is the main area. This will be the reception desk area. Johnny's wife, Corrine's desk and workstation will be right here. And then this will be our conference area here. And I will have a couch here. And probably when I teach my Secrets to Becoming a Diet Guru class, this will be in this part of the, you know, I'll have everyone sitting over there and I'll be standing here lecturing. And this will be great. We could probably get 15, 20 people in here easily. Now, in this room, this will be my wife Amanda and my office. So we'll have a two desks set up in here. This is a nice big office space, and we'll have all the inner workings of what's going on in Species Nutrition and RXMuscle, all the billing and all that stuff that goes on in there. And then the real excitement takes place in this room, which is Johnny's room, we call it. This is this new studio. Right now it's just a big square, but once we get a hold of it and we get in here, we will start setting up how we want this thing to be laid out, where we're going to have our sets, where Johnny's desk is going to be, where all everything we're going to do, lighting is going to be. So it's exciting. We have a clean slate, essentially, an empty white canvas. We could paint pretty much whatever we want on that canvas here. We have internet running through this whole place, which was a real problem to get done, but now it's in, so I'm super excited. We got a bathroom up here. We got a couple storage rooms as well to put all our products and stuff like that we have, and we'll have a little kitchen area here. So pretty much one-stop shopping. I walk across my driveway, I'm at work. Doesn't get much better than that. I'll keep you guys updated as the construction continues here, but it looks like we're moving now. Once we get these windows in, it should be pretty quick.